some cats dancing to some music.
Just no
roll,
way.
Roll the
no
clip.
No way. This
roll
sounds the funny. I haven't seen it.
Funny when I watched it at home.
They like, did you like that, guys?
Yeah.
They liked that a lot. What do you think we should call the cat dance?
Oh, I don't know. Irritating. She looks like a boy in that clip, doesn't she? She looks like a strange round boy, like an egg boy. A boy made of round egg.
Right. Oh,
tasty.
That sounds really nice.
Boy egg.
how long would you last on the dance floor with Kat, Iain?
I would not go anywhere near her on the dance floor.
Really?
Am I the only...
I've heard you've got incredible moves, Iain.
I do more of like a breakdance freestyle hip-hop body pop.
Okay.
Come on, give me the hand. Come on.
Yeah.
Oh. Send it back.
Yeah, that's good. That works when you get 2 6'5+ geezers with massive long arms trying to do it in a 2 foot
space. Can I just
say,
the ladies in the audience are in sexy heaven because there's not only George Lamb, there's me, there's Rav Wilding in this studio. It's pretty hot in here, let me tell you.
And also temperature-wise, it's quite hot in here. What have you got for us next, Iain?
Well, now, there's a web guy called Nigel, who's single, I assume, so he hasn't got much time to, you know, a lot of time to work on the internet, and he's made this little film about Bex getting booted out of the house. Enjoy.
Rebecca is outside the Big Brother house.
Yeah, but what happened was, on Friday, Davina McCall, who's normally so fabulous, right, read out the wrong name, because Mohammed should have been evicted, because he's so boring. And then what happened today was George Lamb, off of the Big Brother's little brother, who's always on the telly, just told me that they made a mistake and I can go back in. Look, I got his signature and everything to prove it, right? So open the doors and let me in, because I belong in there.
I'll deal with this one.
What you doing? What's this? What's going on?
Don't worry. I've got a plan.
That's literally the best I could find on
really?
The
internet. Okay. Yeah, yeah. Are you glad that Big Brother's Vicky Pollard has been kicked out of the house?
Well, I'm glad because I didn't want her to win, but I'm terrified because I think she may be on Big Ears, the radio show I do after Big Mouth, tonight, and I'm terrified that she's going to get her norks out and flash them at me. I don't want to see them.
Don't want to see
her norks
Mario,
at all.
Mario, you had a great little bit in that. Was it nice to see yourself still being included after a lot of people might have forgotten you?
Well, the legend lives on.
The legend lives on. It's Mario. Sorry, my bad. How can anyone forget? Have you two? By the way, everybody, Iain's got a bit of a thing for Lisa.
Oh, thanks, George. Yeah, nice one. Why don't you remind him of that?
Yeah. Why don't you two get naked and fight for the last part of the show?
Like women in
love. Do you want to see that?
Yeah, I'm up for it.
Yeah, are you up for it, Mario?
Possibly.
Okay.
Health and safety,
yeah,
though, wasn't
it? Yeah. Didn't see that. Now, are you aware of the phenomenal success and impact of our ringtones on the website?
No,
you aren't?
Oh, yes, I am.
Yes, you are.
Yes, I am.
Of course you are.
You
picked a favourite, haven't you?
Yes, I have.
It's your favourite lady.
Don't stir up between me and Mario. It is Lisa's ringtone. I just love Lisa's ring. Let's have a listen.
Mimo. 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 Mimo.
That's what happens when a Dalek explodes. Yes. this thing. Yeah.
What do you think you're referring to?
Well, I suspect that Mimo is a reference to Mario's privates. But let's ask Mario.
What is Mimo, Mario?
Daleks and Mimos. Actually, what it is, she called her daughter Mimu, and vice versa.
Right, okay. There we go.
Fantastic.
Can I just say very quickly, I think Lisa stands a very good chance of winning, sir. So, you know, put your money
on her. Your quid's in.
Thank you very much,
quid's
sir.
In.
I agree with you.
Yeah, well done.
Now, whilst we're talking about mobiles, we've got a quick competition for you. There's a chance there for some of you to win some exclusive housemate art. How about that? Here it is. Look. Wow. Ooh. Come on, guys. Look at the amazing hat. There you go. This was done by none other than Stuart and Kat in the Big Brother house. If you'd like to win, text us Big Brother to 83188 for a link to the mobile site where you can then enter our exclusive competition. Iain, it's safe to say, I think, though, we're moving on now to another subject. Safe to say that you've been equally kind of appalled and delighted about our caption competition that we had on the website.
We had some entries for the caption competition.
Should we get the still? Can we get the still?
Let's look at the picture. This is the picture we gave you, and we asked you to send in your amusing captions. The amusing was the word I think some of you missed.
Anybody funny out there?
No. Here are some of the... Anna, he loves me, he loves me not.
Oh, that's fine.
Craig Nicholson says, hair today, nominated Monday, gone on Friday. I don't even get that one. I don't even get it.
But hey, what's the winner? What's
it's
the winner?
By John Nugent, son of Ted Nugent, the rock star. And it's, that's my bikini line done then.
Right. Well, that is the last ever caption competition we're doing. That was rubbish. We're never going to do one again. And finally, you've got something else for us, don't you?
Huh?
The American kid.
Oh, yeah. Okay, there's an American boy in America, right? He's 15 years old. I think his name's Rory Park, and he watches Big Brother in America, and I think we've got him on the line now. Rory, are you there?
Yeah.
Man of many words, Rory. How is it in America?
It's sunny and hot.
Okay, that's good news.
How is it in America? Yeah, that's a terrible question.
Are you watching Big Brother on the internet every day?
Yeah, I am.
Okay, not enough going on in America that you haven't got other stuff to be doing with yourself?
Well, I mean, like, I do work, but I mean...
You're 15, what do you do for a living?
Well, I just, like, work at, like, my school, and then, yeah.
Well, that's studying. That's not work, that's studying. You don't get paid for that, do you?
Well, like, I'm helping around my school.
You are helping around your school?
Kind of, what, litter-related stuff, or...?
What?
Are you picking up litter?
Well, not litter, but, like, yeah. Just
okay,
like,
so a SWAT is an English term for you.
Do you watch with your friends, or are you kind of alone in the dark doing this by yourself?
Well, I'm not alone in the dark, but, I do watch by myself, because, like, all my friends, like, they really aren't into...
Rory, what a pleasure talking to you, mate. Sorry, we've got to cut you off. What a lovely chat that was. And remember, at the end of today's show, you've got the chance to ask the ex-housemates anything. Send in your emails or texts. We'll see you in a bit. Don't go away. It's day 55. The time is 6:34. Let's see how Rav is doing in the camera run. Rev, how are you doing in the camera run?
Doing good, Ashley. We've just seen firearms drawn from Officer Michaels.
Uh-oh.
There. Having a go at Dale for skipping in the house. A clear violation.
Really, what? He's not allowed to do that?
Apparently not. Officer Michaels is taking a hard stance here.
He's just trying to keep fit, though, surely. They look amazing in those outfits.
They're looking fantastic.
What are they doing? They're chowing down. Are they tucking into dinner already?
Lisa's making some food there. I think she's trying to keep the cops happy.
Right, OK. And what about the coppers? What are they up to?
Well, other than Officer Michaels, who's got the gun drawn still, he's obviously ready to fire.
Okay.
Officer Mohammed's not really doing a great job.
Big emphasis on the gun stuff here. All right, Rav, thank you very much. We'll be going back to him in a little while. Now, we're joined by our lovely ex-housemates, guys. After breaking rules about discussing nominations earlier today, Big Brother will be punishing all the guilty housemates. But remember, the lines aren't open yet. However, we wanted to offer our ex-housemates a second bite at the cherry by seeing if they could... who they would nominate. You might be a little surprised. Have a look at this.
My first nomination this week would be for Luke. I think he's feeling a little bit sad, perhaps a little bit obtuse, not really a very friendly housemate. My second nomination would be Rachel. Not sure that looking at her VT last night that she was actually true to who she is when she actually came into the house. So my second nomination would be Rachel.
My first nomination is Rachel. I'm nominating Rachel because she really bores me. She has nothing to offer. She's not exciting. All she goes on about is grapes and come on. My second nomination is Maysoon. When I think of Maysoon, I think, May who? Is she even in the house? She's meant to be a model. I mean, she's not even showing any skin. She's got nothing to offer. Boring.
My first nomination is going to be Mikey. He said in the past a lot of rude things towards like women and stuff and been quite crude, and I don't like that, and he seems to be getting away with it, so yeah, Mikey. My second nomination has got to be Lisa. You know, she's very vacant, sits on the fence, quite a blank personality. She's not a strong character in the house and doesn't really have much to say, so yeah, Lisa.
The person I'm going to nominate this week is Dale. The reason being, he doesn't like children. What sort of person doesn't like children? You can see right through him, and he's a backstabber. Don't trust Dale. Get him out. Get him out. The second person I want to nominate is Kat. little cat. She's nothing but a crybaby. And she's an actress as well. She's playing on people's emotions. She just deserves to go. Cat, stop crying and get out.
Ruckus between Mario and Steph. Good job I'm in the middle, guys. Just remember, health and safety first, Mario. Now, everybody see.